The last video we discussed about the introduction of it is complex number. Now let us move to the next one. The operations of it is algebraic operation of it is complex number. Algebraic operation of it is system of equation. Already we know addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. In the number system, it is different from it is complex number. It is not usually it is addition, multiplication, division. In complex numbers are it is operations are it is different one that we going to see in this video. Now first we come to the first operation. The algebraic operation of it is complex number. First one, scalar multiply. So now let us consider it is z that is equal to it is a plus it is I it is b, a complex form. Already you know what is mean by complex number, and a is called it is a real part and b is called it is imaginary part. So the combination of real and imaginary is called defined by it is complex number. So let us consider it a complex number. It is defined by z equal to a plus I b. A scalar k is belongs to it is integer. K is called a scalar multiplied to it is a complex number. So therefore it is k into z that is equal to k into z equal to a plus it is ib. A plus it is ib. Now just multiply into the bracket that is equal to it is k into a plus it is I into it is k it is b. So it is k z that is called it is any it is scalar multiply into complex number. That is one of the it is operation of it is the complex number. First one, that is called first one, scalar multiply with any of complex number. Then come to it is addition. Again we will take next one. It is the two complex numbers are defined by z it is that is equal to a plus it is ib, one number. This defined by it is z1. Then another one is called z2 that is equal to c plus it is id, is called another it is a complex number. Now we want to adding of two complex number z1 plus it is z2. Z1 plus z2 that is equal to z1 is called a plus it is ib plus z2 is called c plus it is I into d. It is a second one. Z1 and z2 two numbers are defined by z1, z2 are complex number. Now just we want to it is add. So add the real part to real part, that is equal to a plus c is called real part plus it is imaginary part is ib, imaginary part is called id. We can take I is commonly, it is b plus it is d. So in that complex addition of it is two complex number z1 plus z2, that is equal to adding of it is z1 plus z2, and here it is real part to real part a plus it is c. Plus it is imaginary part, add to imaginary part, both the imaginary part, I is common, take I commonly, remaining it is called it is b plus it is d. So adding of it is two complex number, it is addition property of it is complex number. Same one it is for multiplication, subtraction, just be a simple change, it is minus, now it is minus, it is minus. So what is that, it is adding the value, a minus it is d, so a minus it is c, plus it is take it is commonly, b, minus it is d, right, as it is minus. So z1 minus z2, so z1 minus of it is z2. So just multiply inside the bracket, we will get what is the equation. It is a plus it is I it is b minus c minus I it is d. Just combine the value of it, real part a minus j minus c plus imaginary part to imaginary part, it is take I is commonly b minus it is d. So subtraction of it is 2, it is complex number. Now come to it is next one is called multiplication of it is complex number. So we take same it is complex number z1, z2 that is equal to z1 that is equal to a plus it is I it is b, then it is z2 that is equal to c plus it is I into d. Multiplication of it is two complex number. Now what is that? Ordinary multiplication. So multiply it is two bracket that is equal to a into c, ac. Then a into id plus it is I into ad, then multiply plus it is I into bc, and multiply these two number plus it is I into I, it is I square into b into d, it is b into d. Understand? Now that is equal to ac plus it is, right, as it is I into it is ad plus it is I into bc, and I square value we know. What is the I square value? I square that is equal to what? Minus 1. Already we know it is I square value equal to minus 1. Therefore, it is I square equal to minus it is 1 into it is b into d as it is. Now that is equal to AC, then plus it is I into B, AD plus it is I into it is BC, then minus it is BD. Now taking combine the value of it is real term to real term, that is equal to AC minus it is BD, fully it is real, plus these two term it is I is common, take I is commonly, that is equal to AD plus it is BC. Therefore, it's fully it is real it is part, and this fully it is called it is imaginary. For if you have multiplication of it is two complex number, it becomes a complex form. Okay, now come to the last it is property, multiplication of any it is complex number Z by it is I. So let us consider a complex number in the form of it is 2 plus it is 3i, it is real part, it is imaginary part. In this it is a complex number Z, we want to multiply by it is I. So now just multiply I into Z, that is equal to I into Z equal to 2 plus it is 3 it is I. Multiply inside the bracket I, that is equal to 2 it is I plus it is I into I square, it is 3 into it is I square. That is equal to 2 it is I plus it is 3 into I square value equal to minus 1 minus 1. And that is equal to minus 3 plus it is 2 it is I. Now just it plotting of given it is complex number Z equal to 2 plus it is 3i in the argon it is plane. 2 as it is real part and 3 is called imaginary part, x axis is called real part and y axis is called imaginary part, 2 is called real and 3 is called imaginary. Just to plot the point, this point is called Z. Z is called what? It is 2 plus it is 3 it is I. 2 plus 3 it is I. Now we obtain it is IZ. We obtain IZ. IZ equal what? Minus 3 plus 2i. Minus 3 is called real. Then plus 2 is called imaginary. It is called it point it is IZ. And it is point it is called it is minus it is 3. Plus it is 2 it is I. Next we multiply another it is complex number with this number. It is called I is multiply with IZ. Multiply with IZ. Previous it is number is called IZ. That is equal to multiply inside the bracket it is I into I, it is I square into Z. That is equal to I square value equal to minus 1 minus 1 into it is Z. That is equal to minus 1 minus of Z equal to 2 plus it is 3 it is I. Multiply inside the bracket minus minus 2 minus it is 3i. So this call it is what? Just multiply I into I, I square. It is called I square into Z. So now I square Z is number is called the complex form minus 2 minus 3i. Minus 2 minus 3i, this is the place of it is I square into Z. Okay, next we multiply it is I with it is I square into it is Z. So that is equal to I into I square Z will obtain the value equal to minus 2 minus it is 3i. Minus 2 minus 3i, again it is I multiply inside the bracket, that is equal to minus 2 into I, it is 2i it is, and it is multiply this term minus 3 into I, it is I square. I into I, it is I square. That is equal to minus 2i minus 3 into I square value, we know it is called minus 1, it is minus it is 1, and that is equal to minus minus plus 3 minus it is 2 into I. The value of what? It is multiply that term, it is called I power it is 3 into Z. I power 3 into Z. Now already we plotted as Z and IZ. I square into Z, 3 points are plotted. Now we plotted value of I power 3 into Z is called 3 minus 2i. 3 minus 2i, this is a place of it is I power it is 3 into Z. Now from the origin we draw it is a vector it is form of it is 1, it is called OZ value point, it is called vector distance. Therefore it is a distance from it is origin to is a complex number Z, it is called vector form. The another it is point is called it is IZ. IZ it is 1, it is IZ equal to minus 3 plus it is 2i and Z equal to 2 plus 3i. Now it is the vector of it is OZ and it is OIZ. Between of it is 2 it is complex number, that is equal to 90 degree. Therefore it is a counted it is a clockwise direction about it is origin, it is 90 degree. Countered clockwise, and this one is called clockwise direction, and it is called anti-clockwise direction is called counted clockwise. Now it is Z and IZ, between of two it is value, it is 90 degree is called counted clockwise direction. So every multiplication Z multiply with I, it take it is 90 degree counted clockwise. Again it is we have another it is vector, it is called O, it is I square, it is Z vector. The angle between of IZ and I square is called, again it is 90 degree. Again it is another, it is vector is called, it is O2, it is I cube, it is Z. And this it is vector, the angle between of I square into Z equal, another it is 90 degree. And similarly it is I cube Z, it is 90 degree. So generally, every it is complex number is multiply with I, the angle between of the Z and next complex number is called 90. Therefore, it is counted clockwise on this about its origin, it is 90 degree. Next, come to the next, the basic this problem based on it is operation of it is a complex number. In the exercise number, it is 2.1, first two sums are easy to derive. For example, we can take it is two complex number, Z is called, it is 1 plus, it is I. Then another it is number defined by it is complex number is called W, that is equal to 1 minus it is I. If you adding up the number Z plus it is omega, that is equal to 1 plus it is I is called Z plus it is 1 minus I is called it is W. So it is Z and then it is called it is W. Just add in the value real term to real term, it is 1 plus it is 1, then it is plus it is I minus it is I, that is equal to adding the value 2 plus it is 0. So it is called what? 0 I. This is a complex form. So similarly, same it is method, some of the easiest question in the first two exercises that we can easily try. Now come to next, it is example number, it is 2.2. Find the value of real number x and y. If it is complex numbers are given, it is 2 plus I into x plus 1 minus I into it is y plus 2y minus 3. And it is x plus, it is 1 minus I plus 1 minus 1 plus 2y into x plus y 1 plus I. Or it is equal. So two complex numbers are it is given, both are equal, and find the value of it is real value of it is x and y. So what are two complex numbers are given? It one of the complex number is called, it is 2 plus it is I into it is x plus it is 1 minus I into it is y plus it is 2y minus 3, that is equal to another common number x plus it is minus 1 plus it is 2 it is I into y plus it is 1 plus it is I. These two complex numbers are it is equal in given it is question. Now just it is simplify the equation, just multiply the inside the bracket y values. Therefore it is 2x plus it is ix plus it is y minus it is I it is y plus it is 2 it is I minus 3, that is equal to x plus multiply term it is sorry minus it is y. Then it is plus it is 2i, it is y, then it is plus it is 1 plus it is I. Now collecting off it is here left hand side equation, real terms what? X term it is 2x is real term, y is real term and 3. Therefore it is 2x plus it is y minus 3 is called real term. Then it is plus it is ix minus iy 2i. So it is called it is real term, take it is is commonly. X minus it is y plus it is 2, it is called real terms, and that is equal to here real term equal to x minus y plus it is 1 is called real term, then plus it is I into imaginary term, it is called what is it, it is plus it is 2y and it is plus it is I. Therefore it is there is no x term, 0 it is x term, plus it is 2 it is y, plus it is 1. Now it is collecting off it is real part imaginary form for given equation. Now just it is equating this, it is real part to real part and imaginary part to imaginary part. So now first comparing of real part to real part, what is the real part? It is 2x plus y minus 3 and equal to it is x minus it is y plus it is 1. So 2x plus it is y minus 3 is equal to x minus y plus it is 1. Both real parts are equal because of it is the two complex numbers are equal, the real is equal to real and imaginary equal to imaginary. Therefore, it is just it simplifies the equation, all the term transferred to left hand side equation, 2x minus y plus it is y, then it is plus it is y minus 3 minus 1 equal to 0. Now simplify the equation, sorry it is x. So therefore, it has a separate value x, then adding value plus 2y minus it is 4 equal to 0, we call this equation is called 1. So real terms are equal, we obtain the equation x plus 2y minus it is 4 equal to 0. Now equating the imaginary part to imaginary part, coefficient of imaginary part equal to x minus y plus 2 is equal to 0x plus 2y plus it is 1. therefore it is x minus y plus it is 2, that is equal to 0, it is x plus it is 2, it is y plus it is 1. So imaginary part, quotient of imaginary part equal to quotient of imaginary part, that transfer all the term to left hand side equation, therefore x 0 in a 0 is cancelled, then minus in a minus it is y, minus 2 it is y, and it is plus it is 2, minus it is 1, that is equal to 0. Now it is x and minus it is 3y plus it is 1, that is equal to 0, simplification. Now call this it is equation defined by it is a 2. Now make simplification of it is first it is 2 equation, we find out value of it is x and y. Now what is first equation? It is first equation that implies x plus it is 2y minus it is 4 equal to 0. Second equation that implies it is x minus 3 it is y plus it is 1 equal to 0. Now here it is both x are it is same, it is 1. Just we ought to subtracting of equation, the x will cancel. Therefore subtract the equation, minus into plus, minus, minus into minus, plus, minus into plus it is minus, both it is x are it is cancel. Therefore plus 3x plus it is 2y, it is called 5 it is y, minus it is 1, minus 4, minus it is 5, it is equal to 0. Therefore it is, we have simplified, it is 5 it is y equal to it is plus it is 5, transfer right hand side equation. Therefore y it is comes it is 1. So now we know the value of it is y, substitute any one of the equation, find out as value of it is x. Substitute a y value in the first equation. Therefore x plus it is 2 into y value equal to 1 minus it is 4, that is equal to 0. Therefore x plus it is 2 minus it is 4, that is equal to 0. X minus 2, that is equal to 0. X that is equal to 2. Therefore it is x that is equal to 2, then it is y. Y that is equal to 1, it is both are it is real numbers. And value of it, real value of it is x and it is y. Okay, let us see the next, it is properties of it is complex number. First one is called it is closure property. What is my closure property mean? If you multiply any two complex number or addition to any complex number or subtracting any complex number, the result should be in the complex form. That is called closure property. For example, now first we can see about this addition operation. So let us consider z that is equal to a plus it is I it is b, then it is z 2 that is equal to it is c plus it is I d. Already we discussed about addition. So therefore it is z 1 plus it is z 2 that is equal to a plus it is I it is b plus it is c plus it is I it is d, second one. Adding of real term that is equal to a plus it is c, then plus it is I into adding of real imaginary term it is b plus it is d. Therefore, this also it is a complex form. First one is called it is a real term, and second one is called it is imaginary form. Therefore, it is addition of it is two complex number. Again, it will obtain a result also complex number. Therefore, it is closer axiom is true. It is similar for it is a subtraction also, and it is similar for it is a multiplication also. If you multiply two complex number, and it is also same, it is obtain a result also a complex form. Therefore, it is the closer property. If multiply, adding or multiplying or subtracting the two complex number, it obtains same, it is complex form. It is called, it satisfies the property of closure axiom. Okay, see the next property is called commutative property. Commutative property, you know, what is the commutative property in ordinary system? For example, considered as it is 7 plus it is 8, that is equal to 8 plus it is 7. That is commutative property mean interchanging the place. Now same it is one we are doing for here, complex it is number. So consider two complex numbers are z1 and z2. Now adding up two complex number, z1 plus z2 is equal to a plus it is I it is b plus it is c plus I d, are two complex number. Now just adding the equation, real part, a plus it is c plus it is I into b plus it is d, adding up two complex number. Now just interchange place, it is commutative. So all the real numbers are satisfying of it is commutative property. Therefore the a, b, c are it is real numbers. Therefore interchange the value, that is equal to c plus it is a plus I into it is d plus it is b. Now splitting the equation, that is equal to c plus it is a plus I it is d plus I it is b. Now combine these two numbers, that is equal to c plus I it is d plus it is a plus it is I into b, and this number defined by it is what, z2, and this number defined by what, z is 1. Therefore it is z1 plus z2 is equal to z2 into z1. That is called it is commutative property, satisfied in the it is addition operation. It is also satisfied, it is a multiplication property also. Satisfied in the subtraction property also. Okay, next one is called associative property. Associative property means what? For example, taking of 3, it is real numbers. Associative property 3, 4, it is 5 or belongs to it is real number. Now it is 3 plus 4 plus it is 5, it is bracket for 4 and 5. That is equal to 3 plus it is 4 plus it is 5. The bracket for here, left hand side equation for 4 and 5, the right hand side equation for it is 3 and 4. The associative property interchange bracket. The same it is method we applying of it is 2 complex number. It is Z1 and Z2 and Z3 are 3 complex number. Therefore, Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 within the bracket, that is same as Z1 plus Z2 within the bracket plus Z3. It satisfies the property of it is associative. And similarly, it is satisfy it is subtraction also and multiplication. What is multiplication here? Z1 into Z2 into Z3. And that is same as it is Z1, Z2 within the bracket, it is Z3. The property of it is associative property, applying of it is multiple operation. It also satisfies the property of associative. Now next we can see it is additive identity. Addition identity means what? It is for addition identity for all entity one is called 0. 0 is belongs to it is real number. If any number adding with 0 will become a same number, that number is called it is the additive identity. Here it is the real number, 0 is called addition identity in the complex number. So let us consider it is Z that is equal to A plus it is I, it is B. Now it is complex form, it is identity is defined by it is 0, that we can write 0 plus it is I into it is 0, it is called complex form. So now it is what property Z plus it is 0, that is equal to 0 plus Z, that is equal to Z. If we adding it is a complex number to addition identity of complex number, it become it is same, it is complex form. For example, simplify the equation Z plus it is 0, that is equal to A plus IB, it is called Z plus it is 0 is called what? A complex form 0 plus it is I into 0. Now adding of real term to real term, adding A plus it is 0 is called A plus IB into 0 is called it is I, it is B, that is defined by it is I. So Z plus it is 0, 0 it is called it is Z. Therefore it is additive it is identity is called 0 in the form of complex number is called 0 plus IB. Addition it is identity is called it is 0, the complex form is called 0 plus IB, it is called it is additive addition identity of it is a complex number. It satisfy it is additive it is property, it is for it is complex number. The next one property is called additive, it is inverse. Inverse, for example, it is 9 as it is number belongs to it is capital R. Inverse for it addition equal to minus it is 9 as belongs to it is capital R. A number and the corresponding it is additive inverse is called minus 9. Same one it is Z, it is a complex number A plus IB, then it is a corresponding it is additive inverse number defined by minus Z, that is equal to minus of it is A plus it is IB is called Z, that is equal to minus A minus it is IB. Z as complex number, then additive inverse is called minus Z. So just right multiply by minus, minus A minus IB is called it is inverse element. It is called it is additive, additive it is inverse of complex number. Now simply write a property, what is that? Z plus minus Z plus that is equal to minus Z plus it is Z, that is equal to identity element is called 0. The property of it is inverse is called Z, a number, and their corresponding it is inverse by applying of addition operation, it become it is identity element, that is called it is property of inverse. Now let us consider the first one, Z plus minus Z. Z equal to we know A plus it is IB is called Z plus it is minus Z, we know is equal to what? Minus it is A minus it is IB is called minus Z, that is equal to A plus it is I it is B minus it is A minus it is I it is B, both are it is cancel and finally you become it is 0. 0 is called 0 plus it is I into 0, it is complex form. Therefore a number and inverse element, if you multiplying of addition operation, it become it is identity element. Therefore it satisfies the additive, it is inverse property. The next property is called distributive property. We can take it is 3, it is complex number Z1, Z2, Z3. now it is applying of it is distributive property z2 into z2 plus it is z1 into z2 plus z3, that is equal to just applying of distributive property multiply multiplication z1 into z2 z1 into z2, then it is plus in the middle, then multiply z1 into z3 z1 into z3. This is a property of it is distributive property, distribution of multiplication over it is addition, over it is addition. And similarly, another it is multiplication also possibility. Therefore, it is the property of distributive property z1, z2, z3 are the three complex number. Z1 into z2 plus z3 applying of distributive property z1 into z2, z1 into 2 plus z1 into z3, z1 into z3 property of it is distributive property about it is complex number. Now, same one it is for it is multiplication. Multiplicative it is identity, multiplicative identity is called. A number is considered as it is 7, it is belongs to it is a real number. Multiple inverse, that is called what? 1 by it is 7, it is also belongs to real number. A number it is called 1 by 7, and 7 is number, 7 number it belongs to it is real number. Inverse it is called it is 1 by it is z. And what is called multiple, it is identity. For example, a number is called it is 7. If you multiply with it is 1, it become it is same 7. Therefore, it is 1 is called it is multiple, it is identity. So now the same it is property we applied for complex number. A number is defined by it is z, that is equal to a plus it is i, it is b. Here it is multiple, it is identity defined by 1 in the complex form equal to 1 plus it is i into 0. Multiple identity is defined by it is 1 and in the complex form equal to 1 plus it is i into 0. Now what is a multiple identity property? 1 into is 1 z into 1, that is equal to 1 into z, that is equal to z. A complex number multiply with the identity element is called 1, it became it is the same it is complex number. Now take it is z into 1, that is equal to z equal to a plus it is I into b, then into 1, 1 is called what? It is 1 plus it is I into b, I into it is 0. Now multiply two numbers what? A plus it is this element is called 0 and plus it is I into b, this element is called 0. Therefore, just write as it is a plus it is ib. Therefore, if you define by it is z. Therefore, z into 1, that is equal to z. So, multiplicative it is identity is called 1. Therefore, it satisfies it is multiple, it is multiplicative, it is identity property. A number and corresponding it is multiple identity is called 1, it multiply it become the same number and that number is called it is multiplicative it is identity. Similarly for it is inverse what is that? We can number consider number is called it is z equal to a plus it is I it is b. The inverse element, inverse is called what? A inverse, that is simply we can define by it is omega. Now that is equal to what? It is 1 by z, that is equal to 1 by a plus it is I into b. Now multiply taking off it is conjugate of two numbers. What is that? It is a minus ib by a minus it is I into b. That is equal to a minus it is ib by it is a plus b, a minus b, it is a square minus I into b, it is whole square. A plus b, a minus b. That is equal to a minus ib by it is a square plus it is b square. Because I square value equal to minus, minus into minus become plus, it is called it is what? 1 by z. 1 by z. Now what is the property of it is inverse? Z into 1 by z, that is equal to 1 by z into z, that is equal to identity element is called 1. Multiple identity is called 1. If a multiplication of it is 2 number and it is inverse, the result it is called identity element. Now this number is called z into 1 by z, that is equal to a plus it is I it is b is called it is z into, then it is z equal to what? A minus I it is b into it is a square plus it is b square denominator. Now multiply the value a plus b, a minus b, write as it is a square minus I it is b, it is whole square by it is a square plus it is b square. Now that is equal to a square minus a, again get inside bracket in I square into b square, I square value equal to minus 1 minus plus it is b square by it is a square plus it is b square, that is equal to cancel it is 1. Therefore, a complex number z 1 by z is called multiplicative inverse element. If you multiply, it become it is the ideal element, it is 1. It satisfies it is multiplicative inverse, it is property satisfied for it is a complex number. Okay, let us see the some of the example related to it is the property of it is complex number. Let us consider it is z1, z2, z3 are it is complex number. Just it is, we want to it is show that it is a property of it is a associative property z1 plus z2 plus z3 within the bracket, that is equal to z1 plus z2 within the bracket plus z3, it's associative property. z1 into z2 plus z3 is equal to z1 into z2 plus z1 into z3 by applying of it is distributive property. Now let us see first one, it is first property, and let us consider the left hand side equation, that is equal to z1 plus it is z2 plus z, it is 3. Now first we want to find out within the bracket term, it is called z2 plus z, it is 3. What is z? It is 2, 1 plus it is 2, it is I, z2. Then plus it is z3, 3 plus it is 4, it is I. Now adding of real term to real term, it is 4. And imaginary term, adding the value, it is 2 plus 4 equal to 6, it is I. Now just left hand side equation, z1 plus of it is z2 plus z3. And that is equal to z1. Z1 is what? 2 plus it is 2 plus it is 3i. It is called z1 plus it is within the bracket is called 2 plus z2 plus z3. Just we apply the value equal to 4 plus it is 6, it is I. Just add the value real term to real term, 2 plus it is 4 equal to 6 plus it is imaginary term, it is 9, it is I. We call this equation is 1, it is left hand side equation. Now similarly find out as it is right hand side equation, what is the bracket term? It is right hand side equation, that is equal to z1 plus z2 within the bracket plus it is z3. Just adding a first two term z1 z2, z1 plus z2, that is equal to z1 equal to 2 plus it is 3i, z it is 1 plus it is z2 equal to 1 plus 2i. 1 plus it is 2i. Just adding off it is real term to real term, that is equal to 2 plus 1 equal to 3. And imaginary term, 3 plus it is 2 equal to, it is 5, it is I. Now just adding of total bracket, z1 plus z2 plus it is z3, that is equal to z1 plus z2, just we apply in the value, it is what? 2 plus it is 3, 3 plus it is 5, it is I, plus it is z3, z3 equal to 3 plus it is 4, it is I. Now adding the real term it is 6, imaginary term is equal to 9, it is I. Just we call it is equation is 2. Now comparing of it is equation 1, 6 plus it is 9i, and comparison the second equation 6 plus is 9i. Therefore both are it is satisfied. Therefore associative property is true. Okay, now see the next second property, second one. The left hand side equation, that is equal to z1 into z2 plus z, it is 3. z1 is 2 plus it is z3. Now first we want to find out as it is within the bracket term. z2 plus z3, that is equal to z2 equal to 1 plus it is 1 plus 2, it is I, plus it is z3 equal to 3 plus it is 4, it is I, that is equal to adding the value, it is 4 plus it is adding these two value, it is 6, it is I. Now find out full of this left hand side bracket, it is called z1 into z2 plus it is z3. What is z1? z1 equal to 2 plus 3i. 2 plus it is 3i, it is called z1 into this bracket, just now we obtained it is 4 plus it is 6 into i. Now multiply, complex multiplication, it is multiply this number, it is 2 into 4 is called it is 8 plus it is multiply it is 12, it is i, 12 into 12i, then multiply it is plus it is 12, it is i, multiply these two number, it is 18 into i square. Now adding of it is term, I square value equal to minus it is 1, minus 1. Therefore adding the value, it is 8, that is equal to 8. Adding of it is I value plus it is 24, it is I. Then it I square value equal to minus 1, it is minus it is 18, minus it is 18. Now that is equal to adding of real term, that is equal to minus 8, minus 18 plus 8, I can separate the value minus 10. Plus 24 it is I, and that is called it is left hand side equation. We call this equation that is equal to 1. Left hand side equation, what is left hand side equation? Z1 into z2 plus z3, we obtain the value equal to minus 10 plus it is 24 i. Now come to the right hand side equation, it is right hand side equation that is equal to z1 z2 plus z1, it is z, z1 plus into z3. Now first we want to multiply the two complex number z1 into z2. What is z1? 2 plus 2 plus it is 3i is called z1 into z2 equal to 1 plus it is 2 into I. Just multiply ordinary multiplication of complex number, it is 2. Then plus multiply it is plus it is 4 into I. Multiply plus it is 3i. Multiply plus it is 6, it is I square. I square value equal to what? It is minus 1. That is equal to 2 adding of 2 number plus it is 7, it is I, 7i, and minus it is 6. Minus it is 6. And that is equal to subtracting of these two numbers, it is minus it is 4, plus it is 7, it is I. That is value of it is z1 into z2. Z1 into z2. Now just multiply another it is number is called z1, z3. That is equal to 2 plus it is 3, it is I, into z3 equal to 3 plus 4i. 3 plus it is 4 into I. Just multiply the number, it is 2 into 3, it is 6. Then 2 into 4 equal to it is 8, it is I. 3i into it is 3 is called it is 9, it is I. 3i into 4 is called it is 12, it is I square. I square value equal to what? Minus it is 1. That is equal to 6 adding the value, it is called it is plus it is 17, it is I. Then multiply adding value minus it is 12. That is equal to minus it is 6. Minus 12 minus 6 minus 12 plus 6 called minus it is 6 plus it is 17 I. That is value of it is z1 into z3. Now adding of the two term z1 into z2 plus z1 into z3, that is equal to z1 into z2 equal to minus it is 4 plus it is 7 it is I. It is called z1 into z2 plus z1 into z3 equal to minus it is 6 plus it is 7, 17 it is I. And it is equal to minus 4 plus 7 it is I, minus 6 plus it is 17 it is I. And it is equal to adding the term, adding a value it is minus 10. And adding these two numbers is called plus it is 24 it is I. Now it is called this equation is 2. Now look at this first and second equation. First equation minus 10 plus 24i. Second equation also minus 10 plus 24i. Both are it is satisfied. Therefore it is the distributive property of it is 2 complex, 3 complex number. It satisfies the property. Okay, dear student. Today we discuss about it is algebraic operation of it is complex number. In addition to that, it is property of it is complex number. That is exercise number 2.2 and it is 2.3. Just now we discussed some. The few sum you going to try as it is our homework regarding of it is exercise number 2.2 and 3 sums are there and 3 sums are model sums are we have completed here. That's all the 3 sums you continue as homework. And again it is 2.3 also we completed as regarding it example sum and models are completed in this video. You try that 2.3 as all 3 sums are there, that is also has homework. Now let us see the next video as it is some of the properties, interesting property in complex number. Thank you one and all.